Hello, everybody. So today we'll talk about weather and climate and how climate is changing, any evidence that we have about a changing climate. My name is Zohir Chaudhary, and let's begin. So what is the difference between weather and climate? First of all, we use both words almost interchangeably in daily life, but actually they have a very different meaning. Weather, it's a state of the atmosphere, and the way we measure is with respect to temperature, precipitation, cloudiness, and wind at any particular time and place. So we say that the weather at this moment is cold and chilly. The weather is rainy and gloomy, or right now the weather is sunny. So the weather can actually change at any point of time. It can be cloudy in the morning, sunny later on, and then cloudy again. So the weather is changing. Also, the weather, like in the downtown location of a city, could be different than the coastal area of the city, as well as be different from the inland location of a city. On the other hand, climate is actually the average weather conditions. The same variables, like temperature, precipitation, but expressed in an average manner. So how long would this average be? The average is typically anywhere between 30 to 50 year averages of temperature and precipitation pattern in that location. So what we'll see is that this temperature, precipitation, as well as wind and other variable as well, once you average them, you start seeing a pattern. For example, in San Diego, that's where I live, the temperature stays more or less in the 60s and 70s. Occasionally we get some 80s and 90s, but typically we get a lot of 60s to 75s almost year round. So the temperature remains more or less stable at 60s and 70s throughout the year. In the winter time we get a little bit of rain. In the summertime it's very, very dry. So the climate in San Diego would be a Mediterranean climate with the temperature that is between 60s to 70s, with wintertime rainfall and summertime dry condition. So when we say that climate is changing, we are pointing to this average temperature and precipitation pattern that are slowly changing in one direction or the other. So imagine that the temperature slowly starts rising over 1 year. You have a hot year. Do you think the average will change because one hot year? Probably not. Now let's say the second year is also hot. Do you think that that 30 or 50 year average will start changing because of two back-to-back hot temperature? Probably not. Now if you have 3 or even 4 years of back-to-back relatively hot temperature, still that average will not change. But if you start having 10 years of more or less warmer and warmer weather, progressively warmer and warmer weather, you start seeing that that average has shifted slightly upward, maybe by 0.5 degree upward, maybe by 1 degree upward, that average. At that time, we slowly start saying that the climate is warming in that location. In the same manner, if precipitation starts decreasing because of progressive droughts, 1 year, 2 year, you may not say you have a drought, but then as you start, well, you'll say you have a drought, but you'll not say that your climate is changing. But then as slowly the precipitation starts declining more and more and more over 5-6 years, you start saying that you have a progressive drought and the weather and the climate is slowly drying with less and less precipitation. Especially if the climate projection is also like that, you start seeing that the climate is changing to a warmer and drier condition in this location. So what are the factors that determine climate? So of course, we already know quite a few of them, because latitude is one. As you go to the polar region, it becomes colder. As you are in the equatorial region, it's much warmer. Altitude, also, as you go up in the mountain, it gets colder and colder, whereas if you are in the valley, typically it's warmer. Proximity to ocean. So if you are near the ocean, typically you'll be more or less temperate climate. As you slowly go up in the mountain, on the other side of the mountain in here, the cloud will have lost most of its rain in the, we call it rain side of the mountain, and then on the other side, lee side, it'll be a rain shadow, and we'll start seeing deserts appearing on the other side because the cloud doesn't have enough rain for it to precipitate. So local terrain such as this also influence climate. Human also is a strong influencer of climate. With increasing population, urbanization, industrialization, deforestation, we can actually affect the climate significantly. Quick concept check. Which of the following factor or factors do not determine the climate of a location? Think about it. Altitude, geology, proximity to ocean, two of the above, or latitude? That's correct. Geology does not affect the climate because the other one does. Altitude, proximity of the ocean does. And you can go back to the slide to check this. So, quickly summarizing, over the years, scientists have been measuring various climate indicators to see what's going on. So, and there's been a lot of observations. So, for example, let's look at glaciers up in here. The glaciers in the mountain are an indicator that there is enough precipitation and enough cold temperature up in the mountain to preserve the snow and the ice over time. And scientists have observed over the last almost 100 years or so that glaciers have been disappearing, and they have become smaller and smaller and smaller and have been retreating. As glaciers have been retreating, scientists have also seen that the freezing season has been shrinking in various locations of the world. The lakes are less and less icy, or the ice breaks much sooner than earlier time. And in many places, there's also overall less snowfall, or the snow is appearing later and later and later in the year, leading to a smaller duration of winter time. In many places, scientists have also measured temperature, and the temperature has been increasing steadily in many, many locations. As a result of the rising temperature and the snow melt in various places, the snow has led to the water to essentially go to the ocean. That's where all the water goes anyway. And that has led to a slight sea level rise over time that has been measurable. So sea level has been rising. With this, we are also seeing extreme weather patterns. So a lot of rainfall in some areas, leading to floods. And the location that we see this is consistently in the North and South Americas, as well as Northern Europe and Northern and Central Asia. By North America, is mostly in the northeastern part of America that we are seeing extreme rainfall events. As in some areas, we are experiencing extreme rainfall. In other areas, we are experiencing extreme droughts, such as in the Sahel, which is an area south of the Saharan Desert that is progressively becoming more and more desertified because of the increasing droughts in that location, as well as in the Mediterranean, Southern Africa, and parts of Asia. And where I live, also, we are experiencing a lot of droughts, which is in San Diego, California, as well as Southern California. We are seeing significant drying of the weather. And as the weather becomes drier, in some areas, we're seeing heat waves. And as heat waves, dry conditions couple together, it can lead to drying of the vegetation, which leads to increasing wildfires. So in some areas, we are seeing extreme rainfall, other areas, droughts and wildfires and heat waves. So progressively, scientists have seen that the climate has been really changing over the last 50, 60, and some for some parameters as much as 100 years. And this graph in here shows indicators of warming world. So the black shows declining trends. These are like permafrost retreating, spring is coming earlier and earlier, ice sheets is declining, sea ice is declining, sea ice is all of this ice floating on the ocean, and the other things are rising. And all of these indicators together, they are consistent with a warming climate. Think about each of the indicator pointing down, each of the indicator pointing up, and see if you can make sense why something is pointing upward, increasing, why something else is pointing downward, because all of this should lead to one issue, that the world is warming. All of these evidences, they are actually one chapter from IPCC, which is the International Panel of Climate Change. It's under the United Nations umbrella. They're located in Switzerland, Geneva to be exact, where they have it's a big group of scientists coming from all over the world, representing a lot of countries, almost all countries, UN countries, and they have come to an agreement that each of these things are happening to this big publication, and you can look at it online as well. All right, so that's the end of this lecture. Thank you for listening.